Now, I've done other videos on the importance of omega-3 fatty acids, but I want to talk about how you can spike your omega-3 fatty acid levels just using purified bile salts. The liver makes bile, okay? It's like a detergent that helps break down fats, and it makes what's called primary bile salts. In your colon, you have microbes that make secondary bile salts. So you have two different sources, and they kind of work together to be recycled to help you digest and extract key things you need from fat. Fat in your body is used for many things. One is for fuel, and there's also non-fuel purposes for fat as well. For example, you have the fat-soluble vitamins, vitamin A, D, E, K1, K2. That's very, very necessary. But you also have another group of fats that's really, really important, and that's the essential fatty acids. I'm talking about the omega-6 and the omega-3. And you actually need both of these right here. The problem is that an average American is way, 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 way too heavy on the omega-6 and barely has any omega-3 fatty acids. And there's a really simple, cool test that you can figure out what your ratios are with a simple drop of blood. I will put a link down below to get more information on that. But typically, the average person needs to increase more omega-3s and decrease the omega-6. This would be like corn oil, soy oil, canola oil, safflower oil, all those right here. This one would be like DHA and EPA. These type of fats are very anti-inflammatory. These type of fats are very inflammatory. So what are the symptoms that could occur if you're low on omega-3 and you're too high on omega-6? Well, number one, you're going to have inflammation, okay? Number two, you're more at risk for heart problems. Number three, you're going to have problems with your vision. Could be a lot of different vision problems. Next one, you can have cognitive issues because DHA supplies a good portion of the brain, and without DHA, it can affect the cognitive function as well as your mood, simply because your hormones also need omega-3 fatty acids. There's one thing about making sure you get these from the diet, but there's the other problem of making sure they're broken down and getting absorbed. And I believe a great majority of the population just does not have enough bile because they have liver damage to be able to really break down the essential fatty acids. So even though they're consuming oils and taking supplements, they're not really seeing the benefits. Bile salts can help you with that. And if you need more information about bile salts, I put a link down below. The other thing to focus on, which is also missing, is the source of the majority of omega-3 fatty acids. Fish and shellfish, okay? And you can also do canned sardines, canned tuna to get omega-3. A while ago, I had this idea in my head that I thought that if you're going to can fish, it's going to destroy all the omega-3 fatty acids, okay? And so I did a video on that. And then I felt a little weird about not actually testing it myself. So I basically spent $4,000 and I sent some canned tuna and canned sardines to the lab to have it independently tested to see if it actually had any omega-3 fatty acids, because they have to heat up this fish before when they can it, right? Guess what? It was loaded with omega-3 fatty acids, both DHA and EPA. So apparently they're able to survive that amount of heat. And I did put that video down below where I get into the amounts and the testing and all that. You can check it out. But the point is that we need to consume more fish, more shellfish. And if you want to do the can, you can do that as well, because that will have the omega-3. I'm just emphasizing the importance of this right here. One of the top symptoms of an omega-3 fatty acid deficiency is scaly, dry skin. So if you have that, then we know that you're deficient in that. Also, another symptom would be skin atrophy. Okay, so your skin is starting to become loose. It's not as toned. That's an omega-3 fatty acid deficiency. Your memory is not that sharp. That's another symptom. And the last one is any type of itis, you know, arthritis, bursitis, tendonitis, because a lack of omega-3 puts your body in a state where you're inflamed in the joints and in other places. Number one, make sure you include more fish. And you can also do fish oils, or even better yet, cod liver oil, because that will give you not just DHA and EPA, but also vitamin A and vitamin D. And if you find that it's not breaking down, you may need to get some purified bile salts. And I put a link down below for more information on that. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back.
With another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely, you have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple. We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.